But this morning I want to focus on the darkness, to talk about the deliverance that God has in the light. The first thing we need to deal with is demons. Say demons. Yes. What is a demon? Now, some people believe, oh, it's a spirit of a dead person. Like, I had an uncle that died, and, he was really a devil, and he's going to come back as a demon. No, that's not a demon. A demon is a spiritual being, and most theologians believe that it is a fallen angel, because one time there were all the angels that worshiped God, and the highest angel was the archangel Lucifer. And he walked among the beautiful stones of the sapphires, this beautiful reading of the Old Testament, where it talks about he was the light bearer. I mean, he's the one that was right next to God. And he had the privilege of going into the presence of God and reflecting the presence of God. But then he made a mistake. He said, you know, I'm going to arise, and I'm going to take God's place. I'm going to raise myself up. I will do that. And in Isaiah 14, Lucifer literally says that I will be like God. I will replace God. And that's when he earned the title of Satan or the devil. God cast him out of heaven. And according to Revelation chapter 12, and most scholars believe one-third of heaven, one-third, one out of three angels in heaven, followed Lucifer into hell and were cast out of heaven as well. So there's one devil. There's one enemy, Satan primary, and there are many demons. And what an angel is to God, a demon is to Satan. What an angel is to God, a demon is to Satan. So we rejoice at the provision that God makes for us through messengers, through angelic interventions, through watching our backsides when we don't realize it. But we also need to be aware that there's an enemy out there who has a garrison. Even though they're outnumbered 2-1, they still come to steal, kill, and destroy, to carry out the enemy's mission. Because the enemy cannot strike directly at God, but he can strike at you. And you are precious to God. And God will do anything to keep you safe in his hands and to keep you provided for. Now, I believe that today there are two big mistakes that Christians make regarding demons. Number one, we overemphasize demonic influence. Again, I'm going to age myself, but how many of us remember Flip Wilson? And what was he famous for saying? The devil made me do it, right? Blame everything on the devil. We overemphasize the devil. There's a demon under every rock. You know, oh gosh, I don't have any money. The devil, you know, this is really affecting. No, what the devil? You went out and you bought too many clothes and you spent too much on charge cards and you had too much lattes at the espresso place. I mean, the devil didn't make you do that. But not every problem is caused by demons, and no, the devil didn't make you eat the whole thing, okay? We want to blame that, we want to blame it, but he didn't do it, you chose to. But the other end of that, and that's a very real problem because we overemphasize, some people do, the demonic influence, but the other extreme of that is we underemphasize. Or we underemphasize demonic influence. Because not every problem, but most problems, are caused by forces of darkness. Again, the enemy is going to do everything he can to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus said, the thief comes not. For those three reasons. Who does he steal, kill, and destroy? The people of God. That's who he attacks. He cannot attack God directly, but he can attack God's most prized possessions.